everybody. I'm Bella. I'm a bootblack. I'm from Kentucky State Bootblack 2009. And I was a recent competitor at GLLA. What we're going to go over tonight is basic bootblacking. We're going to do a high shine boot first, which I'm going to do just on my own. And then we'll do an oil tan, which is a different kind of boot, but still something that needs to be taken care of. The first thing we're going to go over is the basic things you want to have in your bootblacking kit. Just the basic starters. I do have a stand. That's not required by any means, but I do actually have one. For oil tan boots, one of the first things you might have is something called Hubbard shoe grease, or you can have Meats foot oil. Both are the same product, pretty much, but Hubbard's is kind of a gel form. Though they're ultra conditioning, but they don't actually put a wax buildup on the shoe, because oil tan are meant to be kind of dull, and you don't want to try and put a polish on it. Another thing you want to have is, of course, edge dressing, which goes around the bottom of the shoe to restore, because as you walk on it, it wears out, and it gets dirtier and darker. You always have water, which I have a small bowl of water. You want to have horsehair brushes. I have about 12,000 of these. Small circular ones are for putting your polish actually on. This horsehair brush is actually for buffing afterwards, and I have some small ones that are shaped like toothbrushes, and those are for going around the edges to make sure you get all the dirt out. So you just want to have those. They're really inexpensive, and they last a really long time. The odd one that you want to have is knee-high pantyhose. These actually work for bringing up the China fan on a high-shine boot really, really well. If you're a girl, just use your old ones. It works just as well, and you're not going to wear them again. I always keep two tips in mind. The reason being that you can get polished up in your little boot holes. So in each eyelet, you can take a Q-tip and go around the middle just to get all the polish off the hardware so that you don't stain your laces. A lot of my friends wear different colored laces. So if you get polish stuck in there, then you dye their laces and they get a little upset with you. If you want to have polish, I have a bunch of different brands. You always want to keep a cream polish and then a couple different wax polishes as well as your Hubbards. I have Lincoln, which is very popular at North. I also have the different TVs. We also have Meltonia, which is a cream polish, which you can use to go over any imperfections in the boot to try and cover them up every time. You also want to make sure, you always want to have black. Black is the most common color. You usually want to have brown. I keep a blue or red for highlighting on the boot, and you always want to have neutral in case somebody has funky stitching. That's why I brought mine tonight. I have stitching across the side of mine when mine are harder. You would not use black across the side of mine because you would dye all this white and pink. So you would use neutral to go over so that you don't stain my prints. I keep gloves in my kit as well, largely so that I don't stain people's laces if they don't have a black lace. And the last thing that I really keep in, other than cleaners, is what's known as a grease pencil or a China marker. I have these in like every color imaginable, including orange. And no, I don't know why I have orange because I've never met anyone with such laces, but basically what they're for is going over stitching in different colors, and it restores the color once it's gone. Dr. Carter, of course, used a lot of yellow, so I use my yellow one. Those are your basic tools. I have a couple different cleaners, and you'll find that everyone's pretty much up in there on cleaners. I have a liquid saddle soap. There's Lexol. This one is probably the most excluded cleaner that we use because people claim that it's toxic. It's actually not a toxic product to anything, but a lot of people have an allergy to this. So you really want to be careful because a lot of people have an allergy to the different detergents in here. It's not toxic to anyone except for those. And if they touch it, lick it, anything, they're going to break out and it's going to be pretty ugly. I also have a saddle soap, which is a paste. Liquid is easier to use personally for me, just because it's easier. So basically, getting started, you always want to make sure you completely strip the boot as far as taking the laces out. You just want to be able to clean everywhere. Another key thing to remember if you're doing someone else's boots, not your own, watch how they lace. Depending on how long their laces are, they may lace funny. I lace over, which is different for a lot, but a lot of people have different forms of bow lacing or a spiderweb lace, and you need to try to match it unless they tell you otherwise. make sure that you're going to be able to get a complaint. I use a cotton rag to do my application. So what I do is first I just get a little web. And then you can use whichever product you want. I'm going to use like all the knives you can work with. And I don't have an allergy, so it's either mine or safe. Basically, the first thing you do is you're going to apply metal soap or Lexol or whatever all the way around the boot. You want to get into all the crevices and all the wrinkles.
Drying out. If you burn out all the oil, you're kind of